this wilder beast, oil wilder beast, she's seen better days, and I'm sure she gave years of dependable and reliable service to the occupants of this home. But in this video, we're gonna be taking out this oil-fired boiler and installing a four-zone ACiQ ultra-efficient heat pump system utilizing two high wall-mounted evaporators and one slim ceiling cassette. It's gonna be beautiful. And we're not only gonna give them heat, we're also gonna give them cooling during those hotter months in the summer. Check this out. All right, folks, let me tell you the game plan of this very large two-bedroom home here. We have a bedroom, another bedroom, a bathroom, a kitchen, and a living room. The game plan on this wall, high wall evaporator. In the kitchen, another high wall evaporator to the right of the window. Left rear bedroom, ceiling cassette. Front left bedroom, another ceiling cassette. Now, when you're installing ceiling cassettes, you need to have accessible space above. Fortunately, we have a nice walk-up attic. All right. So, front left bedroom is there. Our floor joists are running from left to right. Same in the back. And we're going to utilize the attic space here to run our line set, drain and communication wire, because I don't want to have all of that stuff on the outside left and right side. Just going to look cleaner. So we're going to come out of here, across, shoot out of there, and head down to the outdoor unit. Now, as everyone knows, I am a huge fan of the ACiQ brand. It is affordable. They make ultra-efficient equipment. Right now we're unboxing. So it looks like we have the ceiling cassette trim. Let's take that out of the box. Packaging is very nice. Very well protected. Yeah, beautiful. Look at that. Beautiful tray. Gorgeous. Look at that. Beautiful. Put them off to the side. Bag of zip ties and a piece of plastic. We have the template. Perfect. Some installation tools, a couple hose clamps, an adapter for the condensate drain, the wireless remote, a Wi-Fi module, and of course, the star of the show, the indoor ceiling cassette, slim profile. Look at that. That'll fit right in between the ceiling joist. Put it off to the side. The cover and some bolts. Not too shabby. All right, folks, we have the indoor ceiling cassette slim model mounted in between the ceiling rafters here. I got my 3/8 and my quarter inch to connect. I got my end cut off. We're gonna flare this with the NAVAC. Automatic flaring tool.
It makes the perfect flare every single time. I personally don't deburr. Your mileage may vary, but there's no need to deburr it. What are you gonna deburr for? You're taking a tool inside of it and making the perfect flare. Some people like to use like Nylog. I also believe in your mileage may vary, and I don't use Nylog, but we are going to torque this down, read the factory manual, RTFM, and it'll tell you. I'm going to do it with one wrench, Derek. and it'll tell you what to torque the nuts to. Let's get that in there like that. Holding back with the larger wrench and our torque wrench on the other. Okay, perfect. The 3/8 is done. Now let's get the 1/4 inch into place. We're gonna cut back. Quarter inch tubing and repeat that process like we did on the 3/8, and then we're going to do our wiring. We use the black wire there. We have a total of 4 conductors: black, white, red, and green. Green, of course, is ground, so I guess that would be a 3 conductor wire with ground, but nonetheless, let's get our 1/4 inch. Flare that bad boy, and then we will make our line set nice, neat, and clean. We'll secure that down, and of course, we'll have to do our drain to outside. Good. All right, so the ceiling cassette trim was already installed, but have no fear, this is actually very easy. We're gonna fold down that door, and that's going to expose our control panel and a switch that is going to kill power on that red, white, black, white, red wire and the green. So you're going to make sure you turn that on when you're done, but you can open up this door. You're going to remove the screws there. This piece, access panel, is going to come out. We're going to remove that screw and that screw, hook up our communication wire from our outdoor unit. 1, 2, 3, the ground, and these 4 connectors go to the terminals on the main control board. All right, right now we are flaring the 3/8 line. This is going to be the front right room, which is the living room on the 2nd floor of this 2-family house. Makes a perfect flare every single time. Every single time. All right, I pulled the straighter core out. I got this little field piece, straighter core removal tool that I'm using. I like this tool because it allows you to see when you take the straighter core out of the body. All right, it's been a few moments, about 5. We're at 195 microns. We're going to open up the service valves here and proceed to B. Here's a unedited raw moment. Look at that. I used the wrong one the whole time. Wah, 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 wah. Take 2.
Wow. This is sexy. Incredible. Wow. And even has a little heat icon right there, letting you know the heat is on. Beautiful. And the high wall evaporator, wow, that looks beautiful too.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, just keeping it real. I'm not too proud of that, but we'll fix it when the time comes, just keeping it real. But the video is about the versatility of ACiQ equipment. We have a 5-zone, 36,000, 3-ton outdoor heat pump side discharge inverter that is connected to 2 high wall evaporators, ductless, and 2
slim ceiling cassettes designed to fit in between those ceiling joists. Can't go wrong with ACiQ. If you're an HVAC technician or dealer, installing contractor, sign up at aciq.com/MikeyPipes. Thanks for watching, guys. Catch you in the next one. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.